Jane Wallace and her team of psychics are spiritual counsellors to the stars.
Oh my God.
Using a range of techniques, they can reveal the future.
Scary.
From their base in the prestigious Selfridges department store in London, they provide spiritual advice to their clients on everything from their personal life...
Oh, you can tell me about my love life in a bit.
Oh, please help her.
...to career choices.
If I've got to choose between a show, I might come back and say, which do you think I should go with?
On today's show, is there a new man in Tina Barrett's future?
I'm going to meet Clive Piercing.
Is it fourth time lucky for divorcee Tricia Walsh-Smith?
Worst men in the world I ain't marry.
And one of the richest men in the world gets travel advice.
And the plane?
No, don't get it.
First client to visit the psychic salon is Tina Barrett. Tina is a former member of pop group S Club 7. But since they split in 2003, Tina has been working on a solo career and has a new album in the pipeline. Tina has set her sights on an acting career and has come to the Psychic Salon to see what the future has in store.
Probably the worst thing you think about when you go into reading, by asking them, oh, is this going to happen, something that you really want to happen, and they go, no.
Tina's session today is with natural clairvoyant Rosa.
All the major lines on your hand tell a story. These kind of lovely pointy fingers that you have here talk about psychic and also musical ability. Now, this is interesting. You see how pronounced it is?
Yeah.
It's very strong.
Yeah.
Okay. And the thumb relates to our sexuality and our sex lives and our sexual energy, if you don't know what I'm saying.
Oh my God, okay. So
and that seems to have left Tina somewhat speechless.
Something about my hair.
But it is potentially good news on the acting front.
I'm just thinking of cinema. Have you ever wanted to do any acting?
That's really
There's
strange
a small
as well.
Part coming up for you.
Oh, really?
Go for it, girl.
Fabulous. Do you see anything more with the music?
You're going to link with someone fairly well known.
Right.
A man.
Okay.
With dark hair. He might have been out of action for a while, and he's coming back in the forefront. Do you understand what I'm saying?
That's amazing. I'm going to be working with a guy who's very well known, who's been out of the public eye for a bit, and that was spot on.
And the person that you marry is of foreign extraction. Piercings I'm being given with this person. I don't want you to be put off.
Apparently I'm going to meet a guy with piercing.
Right.
Yeah.
Lovely.
No, great. Thank you.
But despite the prospect of a tall, dark, pierced stranger, Tina seems happy. Next to go behind the curtain is Maria Lawson.
I was kind of drawn to come down here to find out a bit more, because I'm kind of into all that spiritual world.
Maria's break came in 2005 when she reached the later stages of The X Factor. There then followed a solo album, and now Maria is looking to build on this with a new album and a possible move into television presenting.
So basically, what this is telling me in your life, you've had many fractures, many difficulties.
Jane was very perceptive, and she was able to tap into straight away what I was about, what I was into, where I'm going.
So the writing of the new album...
Yes.
You're kind of semi there.
Yes.
But you keep changing.
Yeah, the direction's changed a few times, but I think
get
I'm getting closer
it.
To where I want to go with it now.
Because what you keep doing is you keep going back to your first drafts.
And there is little time for Maria to digest this.
I love the month of February, so that's a month to conceive.
Okay. Wow. She said that I'm going to have a beautiful baby girl. That's going to be a mini me.
I think for you, I like Blue Peter. I like the kind of 5 o'clock time.
Sure.
Whatever's on ITV, BBC, whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I think for you, yeah, it's a step on the ladder.
Yeah. She felt strongly that I was going to be working in TV again, which is something that I've been thinking about a lot. I'm very excited about it because I felt that energy myself that, you know, okay, I'm really going to go for my music now. I'm really going to go. For work in TV, and it's actually all starting to unravel and starting to happen. So it just felt that she affirmed those thoughts in my mind.
Tricia Walsh-Smith is on her way to see the Psychic Salon.
I'm generally like in the clouds. I'm not often very grounded, which is why I've had trouble, you know, why I get married to rich men and sign dodgy prenups.
Trisha is the star of the hit reality show Pineapple Dance Studio. Trisha has always been interested in all things spiritual.
I believe in the Buddhist theory that this is like all an illusion. Are we asleep or awake at the moment? We don't know.
Today, she is hoping to get some guidance from Jane.
Is that a
yeah. Are you looking at doing a stage show? Anything to do with a theatre show?
It's going to be telly. We're going to workshop.
But on
it.
Stage?
Yeah, we're going to workshop.
Right, okay.
At my own stage school. Jane said also she saw that there was like four shows on the table, which there actually is at the moment.
I'm seeing like the public or your fans are going to be really proud of you.
Really?
And what I'm seeing is just change in the way people perceive you.
I'm so sick of people calling me Barmy.
If they're talking about you, they're leaving someone else alone.
Yeah.
Which is a positive thing.
Despite having divorced her third husband, it looks like love might just be on the cards again for Trisha.
She's got a guy coming in. They've always got guys coming in, you know. Not interested. I think I'll get married again.
Definitely.
Fourth time lucky. Worst men in the world I marry. But there'll be warning signs, I ignore them.
Trisha, we don't think you should do it again either. Psychic Salon's list of clients includes some very rich and powerful people. Today, Jane is off to see one of them, Alki David. As well as being a film actor, writer and director,
Billy Zane,
beat it up.
Kelly Brook, and Alki David Flick.
Alki David is also the 47th richest person in the world. He has flown Jane all over the world to get her advice. And today, Jane has rather shocking news for him and his fiancée, Jennifer.
So, like children, this is a card of pregnancy and fertility. So I know that sounds really weird, but it is also a card of being pregnant.
Hold on.
Because it's a new beginning for life as well.
You can't be a pregnant bride.
Well, that's what I'm saying, so...
Contraception.
And by October 2011, that's when the bump's going to start to show.
Really?
October of 2011 is your most successful month, where both of your foundations are really strong. Now, I just see a big family with you two, so you've got to work out exactly how many children you have, but I'm getting five in my head.
Five?
That's a lot.
Wait, between
regardless
us or including his two?
Excluding.
And Alki's trust in Jane also extends to matters of a more material nature.
And the plane?
No, don't get it.
Are you
sure? I'm telling you that.
Sure?
Well, you'll get it anyway, regardless
of what
I say.
But will I or not?
Why do you need it?
I hate cues.
The boat's a better idea, so then I'll enjoy that more. But the plane, I don't see the point. Honestly, I really don't see the point of it.
Well, that told him on next week's Psychic Salon.
Liam.
That's my son.
Why is Corin Nolan crying at the mention of her son?
Liam, okay.
And get your crayons out, I feel an aura coming on.
I have the ability to see people's energy fields, so I draw a picture